Welcome back to SnowRunner on Hard Mode. In the last episode, we completed the last of the tasks and packed up our vehicles from the Michigan region. We're now in the garage on the Northport map in Alaska. We currently have no vehicles available, so we'll need to deploy one of the vehicles we put into storage, starting with the White Western Star. It will cost $3,500 to deploy a vehicle each time we want to move them to another region. I purchased some 47-inch chain tyres and used them on the GMC in Michigan. The White Western Star shares the same size tyres, so we won't need to purchase them again. I'll also switch back to the low saddle instead of the sideboard bed. We'll also need to pay to deploy the Fleet Star. I'll purchase some chain tyres for the Fleet Star as well. These are quite expensive, but they should hopefully see enough use to be worthwhile. I'll put the sideboard bed back on, as we'll still be using this as one of the main delivery vehicles. The main priority at this stage is to complete any tasks or contracts to open up the main roads around the maps, and the first up is the pipeline construction contract. We'll need to pick up two loads of service spare parts, and the service hub is not far from the Northport garage. Worthwhile picking up other tasks along the way, such as the containers in the river task, even if we won't be completing it until later. Tyre choice in Alaska is a compromise. The chain tyres don't do as well in the mud or snow as off-road or mud tyres, but offer much better grip on the icy sections of roads. Now that the road to the north is open, I'll continue along and pick up the next task we need to complete, which is rock obstacle. The next priority is to secure a fuel supply. There is one trailer nearby we'll need to deliver later as part of a mission. We'll be right back. I'll switch over to the White Western Star, as we'll need to pick up a load of metal beams for the rock obstacle task and a second load to complete a bridge near the port. To pick up the metal beams, I am going to purchase a trailer. There is a gooseneck semi on the Pedro Bay map with metal beams already loaded, but they don't work well off-road, so the cost to purchase the sideboard semi is worthwhile in my opinion. With two loads of metal beams loaded, we can head back to the rock obstacle task. With that task complete, we've reached rank 18. Next on the list is the bridge repair task, which will use the other load of metal beams we have on board. With that complete, I'll switch back to the Fleet Star, as the next task on the list is restoring the bridge in Mountain River. To complete this, we'll need to deliver one concrete slab and then two loads of service spare parts. The concrete slab can be picked up from the warehouse on this map. This mission seems to cause a bug, making it impossible to manage cargo after the first delivery. The workaround is to quit to the menu and then reload the game. I'll pick up the service trailer as we're going to need this for an upcoming mission. With that bridge complete, let's jump back in the White Western Star, and as we're close to the port, we can pick up the cargo container required for the drilling supplies contract. Next, we'll need to head to the warehouse past the logging station to pick up the medium pipes. With everything we need for the drilling supplies contract on board, we can now head to the drilling site. This section of water can be a little tricky to navigate. There is more grip towards the edge of the water, but this also increases the chance of tipping over with cargo on board, as the ground under the water is uneven. In some of these sections, the truck or trailer will seem to get caught or hung up on something. As it was dark, I couldn't see what was actually causing it this time. Trying to use the winch to pull the truck forward wasn't working, but eventually it freed itself after reversing another time. With that complete, the next task on the list is the oil delivery contract, but I'll save that for the next episode. Thanks for watching.